Welcome, everyone. This is the WNBA on 2K Sports. We'll watch the Connecticut Sun in this one as they go up against the Chicago Sky. From the 2K booth with Brian Banifatemi and Tim Swartz, I'm Blake Suniga. Thanks for coming along. Tonight, two great backcourts facing off. Brian, what's the mindset when you get caught up in a showdown with another guard?
The key is to not take it personal, because this isn't a game of one-on-one. Basketball is a team game, so don't get caught up in looking at the scoreboard and trying to outscore your opponent.
Of course. The only numbers on the scoreboard that matter is the game score, not your personal number of points. But everyone on the court, remember this, they're the best of the best. They want the big-time matchup, so it should bring the level up of your game.
Now here's Quigley. Shot clock at five. Dolson, she's guarded by Williams. With the shot, Dolson's shot's good.
Even for a player like Quigley, who is known for her ability to score, you have someone that open, you can't miss her.
Pass to Williams. Jones with it, guarded by Quigley. Here's Williams. A beautiful reverse layup.
Such a great feel, such great touch around the bucket. She made that reverse look easy.
And here is Vandersloot. Dolson guarded by Jones. Here's Vandersloot. Inside, Parker. That's good. And so Courtney Vandersloot gets the assist.
Quick and agile. Parker can do damage in the pick and roll.
Pass to Strickland. Now here's Jones. Here's Williams. Jones controls the rebound and puts it back up and in.
Well, with the developed understanding of the game, Jones uses timing and body control to inhale rebounds.
To Shields. She's covered by Strickland. Vandersloot with it. Pass to DeShields. Back to Vandersloot. Quigley. Off target with the three. And just under 2.5 minutes elapsed here in the first. And here is Jones. Thomas. Parker defending. Thomas, no good.
Well, this is why you need good defenders inside contesting shots.
Yeah, making every shot a tough shot, even in tight.
Pass to Dolson. Fades back. Vandersloot. Back to Dolson. Shoots over Thomas. And even after two offensive rebounds, they just can't take the lid off. Back to Jones. That falls. Nice feed that time from Jasmine Thomas.
An accurate distributor. Thomas keeps her head on a swivel. And look, if you're open, she'll find you.
Some tough offensive sets, and they really want to turn it around.
They got to lock in and need a basket just to regain some momentum.
The shot's good.
That's a precision shot. No room for error on the floater.
The Sun leading. Just over 3.5 minutes gone here in the first. Pass to Jones. And foul called as she misses, and she's going to shoot two free throws.
Well, the transition to the WNBA is not easy, and just ask Jonquel Jones, who didn't play much her rookie season, but she still had an incredible second season in 2017, setting the WNBA record for rebounds in a season.
And she makes the first. Yeah, it was great to see Jones find her way with Connecticut. I mean, becoming an all-star for the Sun and winning 2017 Most Improved Player.
Well, guys, she didn't just set the rebounding record. Jones shot easily over 50%, a huge reason why the Sun made the playoffs for the first time in 5 years.
She's perfect from the line this time.
Well, for the Sky, the problem pretty easy to pick out. Just not a lot of tough defenders on this roster. Games they lose, they usually give up just too many easy buckets.
Now here's the Shields. Wyatt so far offensively searching for her first points of the game. Doesn't get it to drop for her. Great D that time from Shakina Strickland. Thomas outside. Courtney Vandersloot with some nice D. And the defensive struggles of the Sky, something the team knows they need to fix.
Absolutely. The areas of concern are protecting the rim and challenging shooters. And they also have problems rebounding and closing out possessions. All in all, it doesn't make for an easy go for them on defense.
Williams can't get it to go. The Sky trail. On the wing, Diamond to Shields. Back to Vandersloot. Pass to Parker. Outside, Quigley. That's some solid defense from Jonquel Jones. Thomas, right side. Tries again. And it's Dolson with the rebound.
Her shooting numbers slipping this quarter.
Here's Vandersloot. She's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Now here's DeShields. She's covered by Strickland. Knocked loose. It's stolen by Strickland. In transition, here come the Sun. That doesn't go either for Jasmine Thomas. Here's Quigley. And two shots coming up at the line as she gets fouled on the shot. And there's the foul against Connecticut.
Such a fierce competitor. Even at under 6 feet, Quigley has the toughness to compete down low. Well, while some players lost it right away, others like Allie Quigley take a little bit of time. Didn't play much early on, but knew her moment would come someday.
And the first one falls for her. And despite being patient early on in her career, Allie stays in attack mode all the time now.
Yeah, she plays aggressive and looks for her shots. And with the chip on her shoulder, it's pretty hard to intimidate her. And she's just a player that her teammates want her to pull the trigger.
Both shots good from the stripe.
Her first 4 years in the league, can you believe this? Allie Quigley didn't even average 4 points per game in any season. Now she's an all-star pouring in better than 15 per game. What a story.
Now a timeout called by Connecticut. Very little locked in at this point, but sometimes it feels like the best teams are just waiting for the playoffs to begin.
Well, we gotta remember, these players are human. You know, they're not robots. It's a trying season, but this is where leadership comes into play. An experienced player who can grab the attention of the locker room or the bench is vital.
And Brian, I think that coming from a player is different than coming from a coach. There's just another level of respect there. It also helps the coach. Only so much instruction can come out of their mouths before players start to tune it off.
Sky making a change here. Clarendon with it. Pass to Banham. That one is off. And Chicago will come the other way. Right wing. Here's Copper. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
Well, you talk about the love of women's basketball in Connecticut. It just makes so much sense to have a team like the Sun in the state. The college program at Connecticut has paved the way for basketball in the Constitution State.
She ties it up. A big free throw right there. And for the most part, the Sun have found a good amount of success since the move to Connecticut.
Yeah, the team is still looking for their first WNBA title, though. And in Connecticut, I'll tell you, it's championship or bust when it comes to the hardwood. Fortunately, this Sun team is primed for success and are loaded with talent.
And that one drops, so they lead by one. Now here's Clarendon. Pass to Holmes. Back to Clarendon. Tries to snap the cold streak. One up, one down. 2 points with her first shot in this game. Here's Chicago now. Here's Copper. Here's Samuelson. Clarendon covering. Now here's Williams. She's tightly guarded. Clock at four. Samuelson. Here's Copper. Chicago again missing. Here's Banham. No scoring yet from her, but that's likely to change. Pass to Jones. Rhea Holmes on the wing. Here's Banham from past the arc. And Samuelson pulls it down.
Watch this.
Up top, Williams. Pass to Samuelson. Copper, just five on the clock. From downtown. Here's Endor, and a foul on the shot. She'll go to the stripe for two. It's going to be on Jonquel Jones. First free throw is good. And so she makes both from the line.
Well, a lot of young talent on the Chicago Sky team. Diamond DeShields and Gabby Williams are just two of their big names.
Here's Holmes, looking for her first basket still in this one. Here's Jones, and they're gonna count the bucket and send her to the line. It could be a three-point play. And all the names you mentioned for the Sky, very high draft pick.
The Sky has been trading for draft picks recently. They knew this rebuild was coming, doing it the right way, collecting talent over time. Eventually, they'll find another big name to add to the roster when the youth movement matures.
Yeah. sky, Trail. Here's Copper. Pass to Lavender. Williams. And there's the 3 second violation. Here's Clarendon. The putback. It's good on the putback.
She is just tearing it up this quarter, and I don't think this lead is going to go anywhere while she's this hot from the field.
Here's Copper. Pass to Williams. Here's Copper. Four on the shot clock. Let's it go from deep. And Jonquel Jones pulls it down.
They got lucky. They got lucky. And the defense has taken a big chance, leaving her open behind the arc. And I'm not sure I'm okay with that game plan.
That one drops for her.
And she's made 5 straight from the field, coming out strong.
The defense hasn't been able to do anything to stop her, and her team is doing the right thing. They're feeding the hot hand.
And the Sun pushing it up now. Here's Clarendon.
Shot blocked!
Pass to Samuelson. Will it go? Oh, count it!
One of the purest strokes in the game. Samuelson, a feared player from beyond the arc.
There's a 4 second difference from the shot clock and game clock. Here's Banham. Jones with it. Clock at 6. Fades. Here's Plaisance. And she was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws for her.
What a play in attack mode and get inside.
And the defense gets their money's worth on that foul, stopping the layup and not giving up the and one.
And she's got her first free throws of the night right here. The first free throw is good. And that one goes in. 2 from the line that time. Here's Copper. And no good trying to get that one. And we've reached the end of the first quarter. The Sun on top. They're up by 6. Quarter number 2 coming up right after this break. Don't go anywhere. Second quarter beginning in just a moment. And guys, what's your take on the Sun so far?
I love the hustle they're showing here in the first.
It's showing up on the scoreboard too. A lot of second chance points. And as you said, it's due to their hustle.
The Sun with the lead. Now Clarendon. Jones right side. And she uses the glass on the layup.
A budding yet distinguished young star. Jones's unique skills add just this different element to her team.
Here's Copper. Outside Williams. 5 to shoot. Pass to Lavender. Jacks up a 3. Copper, no good.
You know, you watch her and you see her mechanics are totally out of whack right now. She's lost all feel for her shot.
Yeah, and it's not hard to tell. You know, just look at her numbers right now. Nothing is going down for her.
Here's Holmes. It's stolen. Just over a minute gone here in the second quarter. Here's Copper. Out to the wing. Shot clock at 6. Outside Williams. From outside, off the mark.
Even with the decent coverage that time, she has every bit of confidence to drill that 3.
Absolutely, just keep shooting. I wouldn't bet against her the next time she's in that situation.
Now a timeout called by Chicago.
And with the Sun, they have a very deep roster. They get scoring from many different players, and you almost feel like it's someone different leading the charge and scoring every night they play.
We're closing in on 2 minutes played here in the second quarter. And with the Sun and their depth, it's one of the strengths of this team.
They'll all pick each other up if someone struggles. The team plays smart and can attack you from different parts of the floor with different players. Having that fluidity and flexibility makes them a tough opponent.
Now here's Quigley. She's got 6. Tries from the block. Dolson's shot's good.
Scoring inside, it's about a lot of things. To me, touch is most important. And Dolson knows how to get the ball in the hoop.
Here's Thomas. Pass to Strickland. Blazons covered by DeShields. Blazons can't get it to go.
And she doesn't miss many of those, especially with the defender not in the best of positions.
Here's Quigley. Goes up and lays it in nice and easy.
Whoa, the long bomb. Allie Quigley had no fear to let it fly. It's in her DNA to shoot.
Outside Williams. Up top, Thomas. Launches it. Courtney Vandersloot with some nice D. Chicago trailing here. Pass to Parker. Up top, Quigley. Vandersloot. There's the 3. Drains it from downtown.
Just tremendous dribbling skills. It helps Courtney Vandersloot finish drive despite being well under 6 feet.
Strickland covered by DeShields. Outside Williams. Shoots over Quigley. Here's Blazons. And there's the whistle. Fouled hard on the shot, and we'll go to the line.
And what can you say about the playmaking of Courtney Vandersloot? Fantastic vision, fantastic passing ability, consistently near the top of the assist board in the WNBA. Easily one of the best passers this league has ever seen.
The first one falls. And with Vandersloot, she draws comparisons to a player from her alma mater, John Stockton.
And the play style and approach is evident between the two guys. Stockton himself has said that Vandersloot has that special it factor about her, and she just has that ability to see the game. And I gotta say, she's the driving engine on this Chicago Sky team, to say the least.
And here's Quigley. She's got eight. Vandersloot outside. Picked her pocket. Now here's Thomas. Vandersloot defending. Up again.
That's something they need to do more of. Get after it on the glass.
It certainly wouldn't hurt. Some extra possessions would definitely help narrow the gap.
Dolson. And the shot is good.
You can see why she has the best career assist average in WNBA history. Vandersloot, she really just sets up open shots, leaves the easy points.
Now here's Thomas. Doesn't go that time. Courtney Vandersloot with some nice D. Quigley with it. Vandersloot right side. To Shields. Now here is Dolson. 6 points for her. Three on the clock. Releases from 15. To Shields can't hit. The Sun leading. Here's Strickland. Pass to Thomas. Here's Plaisance. Vandersloot defending. Back to Thomas. Shoots the three. She's off on that one. So Chicago will take it the other way.
Nothing's going down for her today.
Here's Parker. Yes, and it's Allie Quigley picking up the assist.
An intimidating physical presence. Parker is at her strongest playing inside.
Vandersloot with the steal. The 15-footer, and it's Chicago with another.
That was a nice little piece of work. Get yourself a little space and pull the trigger.
Now Thomas. Pass to Plaisance. Strickland outside. Down to five on the shot clock. Makes no mistake on the open jump shot. Here's Vandersloot. 5 points in the game. Here's Parker. Outside to Shields. Yep, that one goes.
Showing some physicality on that play. DeShields is terrific at finishing through contact.
Thomas outside. Strickland outside. Stolen by DeShields. Lays it in off the breakaway.
Straight to the bucket with a nice head of steam.
Well, if you're going to throw it down, throw it down hard.
Throw it down hard.
Well, Diamond DeShields is part of an incredible family of athletes. Of course, her dad and brother, both professional baseball players. Can you even imagine the games of pickup in their backyard?
Out of bounds, it'll go to the sky.
Boy, did they ever make a mess out of that one. A terrible turnover.
So both teams changing it up here. And they have certainly been looking locked in offensively.
They sure have, staying aggressive and playing in control.
Pass to Williams. That kick out to Quigley. Four on the clock. Over Clarendon. Got it from about 16 feet. Well, the DeShields family is stacked athletically. You can't forget about their mom, Tisha.
Yeah, Tisha was an All-American in track at Tennessee. When you watch Diamond play, you can see how confident and tough she is. Signs of someone from an elite family of athletes.
Now here's Clarendon. Pass to Jones. That one a little long.
Great look, disappointing miss.
What happened there? I mean, that shot's almost as good as automatic.
I don't know.
Now here is Dolson. And here is Vandersloot. Guarded by Jones. to the middle. Here's Lavender. Excellent D from Alyssa Thomas.
She thought she had a clear path to the hoop, but great work by the D to cut her off.
Thomas, good.
With top shelf speed and agility, Thomas makes driving to the basket look easy at times.
Now here's Vandersloot. He's got five. Pass to Quigley. Now Lavender. Clarendon covering. Outside Williams. Boots over Thomas. They get it back. Quigley. Here's Dolson, and buries the easy one.
And without looking at the scoreboard, I mean, you'd think they were the team trailing and trying to fight their way back with this effort.
Yeah, playing with a lot of energy, a nice uptick in their second chance points this quarter.
Here's Jones. Good work defensively by Stephanie Dolson. Vandersloot with it. Clarendon covering. On the wing, Allie Quigley. No luck on that one. Good work defensively by Jasmine Thomas. Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. And it's Dolson with the rebound.
If she can get to the rim, she'll usually turn it into points, but the defense stood tall there.
Outside Quigley. And there's the foul. It'll go on Stephanie Dolson. That's foul number two for her. And the first half comes to a conclusion in a game that has been very close so far. It's the Sky up by three. Stay with us, folks. We'll be back just after halftime to get the third quarter going. And it's been a back and forth game with no ground given through the first half. Third quarter getting started here. What a game we're seeing from Jones.
Her rebounding, particularly the offensive rebounding, was superb in the first half. She was really battling hard inside.
And that allowed them to get several shots on the same possession multiple times. I mean, her work on the offensive glass has been invaluable.
And now, the start of the second half, neither side jumping out ahead through the first two quarters.
And this Connecticut Sun team, very strong on the boards. Every player contributes to the effort, usually can gain an advantage with their rebound. Well, good defense in the paint, worth its weight in gold.
It absolutely is, and we just saw it right there, didn't we? Without her presence, that's an easy 2 points.
You know what she wanted to do all along? The teardrop.
Chicago leading. And for the Sun, terrific rebounders as a group.
Yeah, Blake, they just do the little things that add up in closing out possessions. It's not just the size, but the effort the team shows. And they've been one of the better rebounding teams for years now.
Just three to shoot. Knocked loose from way back. Quigley's shot is off.
You know, sometimes just because you can make it from way out there, it doesn't mean you should try.
Kind of hypocritical coming from you, Tim. I mean, it wasn't that far out. Anyways, she could work for a better shot than that.
Williams can't get it to go. And so it's Chicago with it. It's a one-point game. Pass to Dolson. Shoots over Williams. Dolson's shot's good.
And what a great play. Totally schooled the defender right back on her heels on that one.
And they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off. They got to score.
Shot's good by Jones.
Her assist average has increased each year in the league. Williams has become a more willing passer. Great find.
Outside Parker. Quigley. She's guarded by Williams. Pass to DeShields. Five on the clock. Let's it fly from 18. It's rebounded by Thomas.
Man, and they're one for four to start the second half.
Now Strickland. Now here's Jones, covered by DeShields.
And Jones gets it to go.
Three consecutive field goals have come right at the rim. The defense better start buckling down.
They're getting exposed and punished down low.
Now here's Vandersloot. She's got five. Cheyenne Parker drives in, banked in off the glass.
Bringing hustle and heart to the court, Parker has become indispensable for her team.
Now a timeout called by Connecticut.
They got to be concerned with all the missed shots. Every team is going to go through cold streaks. But when you go through those cold streaks, you have to find ways to stay productive.
Yeah, and the coach might be telling them to try to get to the line, earn some points on some freebies, because sometimes the free throw line could be your best friend when the shots aren't falling from the field.
Connecticut trailing. Thomas outside. Strickland with the ball. And Parker picks her up defensively. Outside Williams. Nice D from Allie Quigley. And it's the sky ball. Their defense has only allowed 6 points in the second half. Jones outside. And lots of contact there, missing the shot, and will shoot two at the line. It's on Cheyenne Parker.
With a 6'6" frame and indisputable talent, Jones has become a key cog to her team's success.
And this is her third trip to the free throw line in the game. She knocks down the first one.
An all-star in just her second WNBA season. Jones is one of many bright spots in the league.
And she can't hit the second.
Well, they should be in front right now, but she'll be relieved not to have come up totally empty.
Pass to Quigley. And here's DeShields. Just five to shoot. That one falls, coming off Stephanie Dolson's feed.
So much improvement in terms of passing the ball for Dolson. She came into the league at about an assist per game, and she has tripled that rate.
Here's Jones. Well-timed pass, and it goes straight to the bucket for the layup.
You know, I think that it's cool that Williams serves as a comedian for her team, kind of like Blake with us. She's always laughing and trying to lighten the mood.
Now here's Vandersloot. She has five. Gets the bucket and the foul. It goes on Jasmine Thomas.
You know, she might look small, but Vandersloot has a lot of strength that catches defenders by surprise when she goes for the and one.
And she's got her first opportunity at the line here tonight. Yeah, but don't let her fool you. Despite being lighthearted off the court, Williams is all business on the court.
Yeah, she's a fearless talent and does not mess around when she's out there. Courtney likes to play in attack mode as her team relies on her playmaking ability.
She hasn't had much success shooting the ball.
And here is Vandersloot. She's got eight. Six to shoot. Right at the free throw line. Rebounded by the Sun.
That's one she knows she should have drained.
Here's Jones. So she gets the whistle. Contact on the way up. Two shots next. That one on to Shields.
So skilled around the basket. Jones is disciplined and makes opponents work on defense.
And the first one drops.
And you look at the Sun, you know, they're a team with very good efficiency on offense. They have smart shot selection from pretty much everyone in the rotation, and that kind of gives them one of the most dynamic offenses in the league.
And good on the second, so she makes both. And for the Sun, you add up everything they have, and it equals a scary offense.
And this team can just run you off the floor when their shots are falling. Very unselfish amongst each other and hard to game plan against. As a group, they can get scores against any defense in this league.
And the basket is good.
Keeps defenders uncomfortable, and I think it's because of Thomas's ability to play assertive but composed around the rim.
Here's Samuelson. To Shields with it, and it's Jones picking her up. To Shields can't hit.
Well, got it in close, but credit the tight defense for forcing the miss.
Defense like that ups the degree of difficulty on that shot by about what? I'd say 300%?
308% maybe.
Okay, I like that.
Pass to Samuelson. Williams with it. To Shields with it, guarded by Jones. Launches a three, and that's good. Diamond to Shields for three.
Well, you love to see that offensive mindset from to Shields, and really she's showing that she is not afraid to extend her range.
Here's Banham. That shot's good on the assist by Jasmine Thomas. Here's Copper. Williams with it. Pass to Copper. Now to Shields. Just four to shoot. She drains it in as the shot clock ticks down.
She's starting to turn it on now after a slow start.
Now here's Thomas.
9 points in the game.
Down low, Jones. And the layup's good off the glass.
Another good pass, impressive offensive execution from them.
Yeah, passing has kept the defense off balance. Four straight field goals made off an assist.
Now here's DeShields. She's got 11. And she was fouled in the act of shooting, an opportunity for a three-point play.
Well, that's what fans pay to see, right? I mean, DeShields' offensive versatility is so fun to watch.
First trip to the free throw line for her tonight. And a big free throw right there to put them on top.
Third pick in the 2018 WNBA draft. DeShields went on to have a terrific rookie campaign.
Here's Holmes. She hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. Shot's good by Jones.
And they're really keeping that ball hopping around.
Yeah, hip-hopping around, if you ask me. Look, their last five trips have all ended with a great pass leading to a hoop. They are really sharing the basketball.
Here's Copper. Pass to Samuelson. From long range. And the rebound goes to the Sun. They've led by as much as 10. To the paint. Bantam's shot is good.
Looks like they left their defensive effort back in the locker room. They just haven't had the same commitment to defense here in the second.
Here's Copper. Endor. Outside to Shields. Three-pointer, cans it from downtown.
She's having a great half here, exactly the reverse of the first half.
And so here is Connecticut. Thomas outside. Here's Bantam. She's guarded by Williams. And that one's good, Jones.
Wow. I mean, come on, that's 10 straight points in the paint. The defense, it's just nowhere to be found.
They have to start committing more bodies down low.
Here's Copper. Williams inside.
Clarendon covering.
Outside to Shields. Poked away. Shoots the three. And Jones pulls it down. The Sun with the lead. Pass to Bantam. Thomas with the ball. The layup off target.
Excellent interior D right there to force the miss.
Yeah, and unlike you, Tim, her defensive ability is a huge factor. No doubt about it.
At the line for your Chicago Sky, Kalea. At the line for two. Two shots.
And the first one at the line is good. And that's good as she hits both shots. Now Clarendon. Shoots over Williams. Oh, no good trying to beat the buzzer. That's the end of the third and it's all tied up. We'll take a quick break and then get back to the action.
We'll be right back.
And it's time to bring up the State Farm assist of the game.
Well, this is what being on the same page looks like. Fantastic feed and a heads-up play all around.
And how can you not be a fan of a sequence like that? This is what beautiful basketball is all about.
Yeah, unselfishness, just wonderful stuff.
Thanks for joining us again as we get set for the fourth quarter. A terrific game so far. Pass to Endor. Samuelson. Here's Copper. To the inside. Out to the left wing. Perfect on the shot. Wow, swishes it through. The Sun trailing. Thomas left side. That's good by Jones.
Some defensive breakdowns happening now. Their last four buckets allowed have come from very close range.
And giving up these high percentage shot attempts, it's not going to get it done. They need to figure it out.
Now here's Williams. Six on the shot clock. Great D that time from Alyssa Thomas. Left side, Clarendon. Here's Jones. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
Not much resistance on the inside. That's their fifth consecutive make in the paint.
Those looks they're allowing are almost automatic. In fact, I'll just say it, they are automatic.
Now a timeout called by Chicago. You have to like what we're seeing from Jonquel Jones.
She's just in a groove right now. I don't think they can stop her altogether, but you have to make her work harder than she has been.
Sun on D. And here is Vandersloot. Outside Williams. Clock at six. Here's Quigley. No good. And Connecticut will come the other way. Outside Williams. Williams with it, and Williams picks her up defensively. Outside Williams. And a bit of a battle for the ball, and the official signals a jump ball there. Chicago with the ball. Vandersloot outside. It's Gabby Williams on the wing. Just five on the clock. The tray. Offensive rebound. Back to Vandersloot. Pass to Dolson. Another shot, and that comes off the assist by Courtney Vandersloot.
It's really a sign of a great player. Doesn't let a bump here, contact there. Stopper, nice job by Dolson.
Here's Strickland. Vandersloot defending. Now Jones. On the wing, Courtney Williams. Guarded by Quigley. Williams can't get it to go.
And so it's Chicago with it. Williams with it. Back to Vandersloot. It's Gabby Williams on the wing. Oh, and she misses the go-ahead basket. Now here's Strickland, guarded closely. Here's Clarendon. Jones, great positioning on the putback.
They own the paint right now, 10 straight coming from the inside.
They are constantly finding lanes to the hoop, getting great looks in tight.
It's stolen by Strickland. And here they come. Jones right side. And Jonquel Jones gets double teamed. Six to shoot. All sorts of time. And dead on that time. Beautiful shot.
She's got the touch they needed here as this one goes down to the wire.
Yeah, 4 for 4 this quarter, making buckets under pressure.
Now here's Vandersloot. Excellent D from Alyssa Thomas. Jones outside. Strickland outside. Pass to Jones. Tipped away. Vandersloot with the steal. Now here's Williams. And Jones pulls it down.
This game has been very close in a lot of areas, but rebounding is one thing that's gone in their favor.
Yeah, effort and determination on the glass, they really can compensate for a lot of deficiencies.
Outside Williams, pass to Thomas. Shot clock at 6. Down low. Here's Jones. That falls. Nice feed that time from Jasmine Thomas.
She's finding all kinds of ways to get it going right now. What a quarter she's having.
And here's Dolson. She's covered by Thomas. Now here's Quigley. Vandersloot outside. Parker up top. And she can't stop this drought. Another miss. And they're on the break. And the shot goes in.
The ball movement on this run has been fantastic. And it's a big part of why they've been able to get good looks.
Absolutely. The defense unable to react quickly enough to deal with their passing.
Now here's Parker. Pass to Dolson. Quigley, she's guarded by Williams. From downtown, and Allie Quigley, good for 3.
And add another 3-pointer to their second half total.
They came out of the break dropping bombs and are just not letting up.
You love to see that.
Here's Strickland. Up top, Williams. Nice D from Allie Quigley.
She's had an off game, but her team has been able to pick up the slack and get it done here today.
Now here's Vandersloot. She's covered by Thomas. Pass to Quigley. Shoots over Thomas. And that one hits back iron.
Well, that's just not a sight you see very often because she has a great feel for that jump shot, especially when she's open. Every time they get scored on during this run, it seems like it's come from inside the paint. Buckle up on defense.
Yeah, it's time to collapse down and make them shoot jumpers.
Now a timeout called by Chicago.
Coach does not look happy. Their defensive rebounding has been putrid, and they're giving up a ton of second chance points. Scared the clock to work, it's gotta work.
run from us. Louisville, hush money for my young. With Patino, I take on the casino. Stack casinos, get all of you. It's like Primo. Worms, I just opened up a can of those. My mother had a flower shop, but I was Sandra's Rose. Two girls that are like Indiana Jones. I make them walk together like I'm Amber Rose. Yeah. Dad, I got her up to Annie. California girl, sweeter than pieces of candy. Patty all in Nipsey Hood to go live up with Sammy. Type of hood with bandanas, they the family. Head on the swivel, I can, but I can never dribble. Life too short, I gotta get it before they blow the whistle.
And now let's present our Jordan player of the game, Jonquel Jones.
I just love her passion and her fire. Total dominance in this one. No one on the floor can match her intensity.
Silencing the away crowd is something she seems to really enjoy. She's fed off the hostile environment and delivered a quality performance.
Chicago trailing here. Now to Shields. The left wing. Vandersloot with it. And it's Jones picking her up. Down to five on the shot clock. Here's Vandersloot. Steps back and drains the J.
Why not have Vandersloot take the big shot? She's the best ball handler on the floor. I like leaving it in her hands.
Pass to Strickland.
Yo, look this way.
Here's Williams. Here's Jones. Good work defensively by Stephanie Dolson. Vandersloot outside to Shields. And she banks in the layup.
With great focus and intensity, DeShields remains poised during big moments.
Now here's Thomas. Defense right on her. Let's loose for three. That shot, no good. Still anybody's game at this point.
No question, this becomes a very big possession.
And she'll shoot free throws. Clearly fouled on the shot that time. The whistle blows. And there's the foul against Connecticut.
Diamond to Shields. Two shots.
Good on the first. And that brings them within two here. Both good at the line.
She's the player you want at the charity stripe in that situation. I got no doubt about that.
Inside, Thomas. That shot's good on the assist by Jasmine Thomas.
One thing that I'll always respect about Thomas is that when she steps on the court, she has zero, and I mean zero, friends. And it's because she wants to win by any means necessary. A high motor player who does not shy away from pressure. DeShields is a trustworthy option in the clutch.
Now here's Thomas.
Stays even keeled no matter what's going on in the game. Thomas shoulders the load when her team needs her.
Here's the Shields. Takes the 13-footer. Count it! And that shot brings them within just one.
With an inspiring ability to push through adversity, Parker can be trusted in critical moments.
To the paint. Oh, hammer! Wow! She'll go to the Stephanie Dolson picks one up.
Well, they had the foul to give, but you want to use it on the ground.
Well, at least they're stopping the clock, Tim. That's not the worst case scenario for them.
Drops the first one, and that will put them up two. So she gets them both, and it's a three-point game.
That last free throw was critical. Their only choice now is to go for the three to tie.
Time called here. The Sky decide to talk it over. Chicago with it. They trail by three. Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. Outside Quigley to tie it up. Buries the triple. Wow! A tremendous three to tie it up. Timeout called the Sun. Thomas. The long three. Courtney Vandersloot with the block.
Well, she might be a point guard, but Vandersloot can block a shot or two because of her desire.
Regulation has ended, and we are headed to overtime. Don't go anywhere, folks. We'll be back in a moment. If you're just joining us, this one has been a great one. We've got overtime action now, folks. And it's going to be the Sky off the tip. And always a good ride in these post-regulation battles. This overtime now looking to be an exciting one. Now here's Quigley. Here's Dolson. And unable there to get the go-ahead bucket. Pass to Williams.
Strickland with the ball.
And she was camped there in the lane, and she gets a three-second call.
Those types of mistakes are magnified when it's a tight game like this.
They've got the opportunity to get back the lead.
They've been waiting for this chance.
Now Quigley. She's covered by Thomas. On the wing, Diamond to Shields. High arcing shot. That's some solid defense from Jonquel Jones. Drops in the layup for two.
A great game for her offensively. She's been a factor.
Chicago trailing here. Vandersloot outside. Pass to Quigley. Dolson with it. And here's to Shields. Six on the shot clock. The Sun pull it in. They've led by as much as 10. Jonquel Jones goes in. Got that bucket in no time at all.
Well, you gotta like her shot selection today. She set the bar for the rest of the team.
Vandersloot outside. Quigley, she's guarded by Williams. Right side to Shields. That one falls, coming off Stephanie Dolson's feed.
It's fun to watch the Shields when she's playing this aggressively, and when she's on a roll, she can really pick apart a defense. A great feel for when the team needs a big play. Jones is a timely and dependable scorer.
Here's the Shields. Vandersloot. And there's the whistle. That goes on Dolson. That will get her fourth foul of the game. Now here's Thomas. Vandersloot defending. Shakina Strickland for three. The shot will not fall. So Chicago will take it the other way. Side Parker, up top to Shields. And Jones pulls it down.
Bodied her up and made her alter the trajectory of the shot that time.
Definitely. Some very sound defense played on that trip down.
Now here's Thomas. Here's Strickland. Again, the Sun score. What an exciting game here with 3 minutes played here in overtime. Right side to Shields. Quigley. She's guarded by Williams. Outside to Shields. Shot clock at three. Money! What a beautiful shot to bring them within three.
Confidence has never been in question with the Shields, so I'm not surprised to see her bury long-range shots.
Now here's Thomas. D right on her. Sinks it!
The second she got around the pick and shook her man, it was straight to the bucket for the easy deuce. Very well done.
Now a timeout called by Chicago. Your thoughts, guys?
They need to get a quick bucket here. If there's more than 24 seconds left afterwards, they can try for a stop. But if there's less, they're gonna have to foul.
Here's Allie Quigley outside, rebounded by the Sun.
Not quite enough defense that time around. Lucky she was off.
I just hope that was a mistake by the D, because if that's how they plan to guard her, they're going to have serious problems.
And an intentional foul right there. Good as the first free throw misses for her. We'll see if she can nail the second.
A much improved free throw shooter. Thomas is always looking to get better.
And she's able to hit the second one. And that increases their lead to 6. Now a timeout called by Chicago. With the ball. 6-point game. Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. Here's to Shields. That's some solid defense from Jonquel Jones. And now we've got the intentional foul.
Second personal foul. Shooting for the Sun. Jonquel Jones. At the line for 2.
He hits the first one, and that makes it a 7-point lead. And so both free throws good this time. And it's an 8-point ball game.
Yeah, they've been a different team in overtime. They just seem to lose their energy.
Chicago again missing.
It's going to be a tough loss to swallow. They just didn't have much gas left in the tank once we hit overtime.
So we get to see the Sun get the win here. They had to scrape and claw to push it to overtime, but they really came on in the extra period.
What a ride, boys. I mean, thought it might end in regulation, but they came through big and did exactly what they needed to once we got to overtime.
That'll do it for our broadcast, everyone.